Cycle 7, there was obviously only one question remaining. That question, in previous years, the way I've done it is I always started on the last day of class and it runs right until the day before the exam starts. What it is, it's an open-ended question for you to optimize the process and find the opportunities and respond to this method. There's some interesting twists in the approach that gets followed. So you'll see that posted in the next day or two. It's a competition between yourselves to see how other people are doing relative to you, and the aim is to be the first group that gets to the optimum, at the highest optimum in the fewest number of experiments. So using the techniques you learn. So that will be running at, and you just, it's simply, all it is you have to do one experiment per day, type it into the website, and before the final exam, you will be at the optimum. You shouldn't be at the optimum. So, the regular two people use. So you'll see that being posted tomorrow. I'll set that up. Let's also just talk quickly then on the final exam. There's not too much to say about it. It is on Tuesday, I believe. Just double check the dates and times again. Tuesday is 3 hours. It's comprehensive in that it covers everything in the course. 45% of the course grade. The other thing is, don't, as you start to see with my, or know with my courses, it's not about just using equations and just subbing in. It's a lot about interpretation and showing your use of the material that you've learned and the interpretation from the results. Don't just stop at your final answer. Always do a check to make sure that it's reasonable. So if you're calculating, for example, some of these limits, like Six Sigma limits, make sure they actually make sense. People sometimes suggest standard deviations that are negative. Well, a standard deviation can't be a negative value. So there's a simple check built in based on our knowledge. This is obviously, I'm speaking to people that are well used to exams, so starting with the hardest questions first or answering questions in proportion to the time, the grades out of it. Well, then those are standard strategies that people are using by now. But please don't waste your time repeating back values to me. There's no need to rewrite the question back on the answer sheet. In fact, I just skip right over it, so it's useless. Use short sentences or bullet points if you feel that's more easy way to communicate rather than paragraphs. The other notes here for you are people have used the open book system in that they study on the day of the exam or feel like they don't actually have to go through the material prior to the exam. Rather, treat this exam like a form of the cheat sheet if you want. That's a good way to, a good strategy to follow. Your cheat sheet should at a minimum have the statistical table and the DOE table. Neither of those will be provided for you in the exam, I'm assuming that you have them with you. I also provide prior exams for you, so the previous 4 years of exams. In fact, there's more than 4 years of exams on the website. Stuff prior to 2010, however, it's in mind. That's Dr. John McGregor's material on the website. So please use those to study and practice for exams. So there's ample material. There's assignments from last year, this year, as well as solutions. So lots to go on. In terms of topics we've covered, in this course this year, we covered only 5 sections. The 6th section on latent variables, I've intentionally downplayed because spending a week on that makes you just dangerous enough to know that material and not use it properly. So I've seen how people have used it coming back 2-3 years later and it isn't a suitable topic for teaching. It really does need 12 weeks on its own. So what I've done instead this year for the first time is cut out the multi-area section and spent a lot more time on the DOE. And based on your course projects, I think that was a good strategy. I started to see a really good understanding of the design experience in the project. So thank you for that. I'm glad to see that the effort that you put in there is being called for that. Those 5 topics will make up their exam as well. The other thing is, of course, that this websites are always permanently available. The textbook is permanently available. I had this note here last year that the textbook will eventually become an online book. I hope that actually by next year it will be offered an online book. depending on how this group goes. And then finally, just to say thank you for all your time and your input and questions. I appreciate that. Several, many of you have in fact suggested some interesting changes. Did you notice? I always like to say in touch with people that use these techniques and ideas. I get regular feedback from my prior students, so feel free to keep that up. It's always interesting to see people using these techniques in a variety of areas. Okay, so thank you once again. And